India's former ambassador to France, Mr. Rakesh Sood, will be talking about Prime Minister Modi's upcoming visit to France and Europe. Mr. Sood, could you give a sense of the quality of India-France relations at this moment, and how do you look at the importance of Mr. Modi's visit to France, and it's also his first visit to Europe?
India and France have had one of the oldest strategic partnerships. What do I mean by strategic partnership? I mean that we have had long-standing cooperation in areas of defense, nuclear and space, three areas that normally constitute a strategic partnership, and particularly in recent decade or so, we have also strengthened our cooperation in the area of counterterrorism and intelligence sharing. So I think it is a very substantive relationship. And we had President of France, President Hollande, was here in February 2013. Obviously, in 2014, we had our elections. And so it is very opportune that Prime Minister Modi is now visiting Paris and other locations in France.
What are the key issues one can expect to be on the table? And what key outcomes are you expecting from this forthcoming meeting?
Well, one outcome is obviously in the strategic dimension. And as I mentioned, there are four sectors in it. The defense side, France has been a major partner in the defense sector. We use the Mirage aircraft. We are currently negotiating on the Rafale aircraft. We are also building Scorpene submarines, submarine which is being built in Mazagon docks. There are also other areas in relating to missile technology, relating to helicopters, relating to a whole host of other French equipment, which we have traditionally bought from France. And today, it is quite possible that we may see further developments in this area. Another area in defense is the service-to-service cooperation. This is normally reflected in annual exercises, and we have annual exercises between the militaries, the navies, and the air forces. A second thing is the nuclear dimension. Now, France has been a key partner with us in the nuclear field. They had supplied us with fuel for Tarapur when the US had refused to supply us fuel for Tarapur in the previous century, during the 70s and 80s. And more recently, in civilian nuclear cooperation, the French company Areva has been in negotiations with NPCIL on setting up nuclear power plants at Jaitapur. On the space side, once again, as you know, we use Ariane space for launching our GSAT series. So there is a very strong partnership. In fact, French companies use the PSLV, which is an ISRO launch vehicle, for launching smaller satellites. Then we come to counterterrorism. We have focused much more on intelligence sharing. The French, as you know, are very active, particularly in West Africa, which is a region of great concern to them. And today, we see that we have the evidence of Al-Qaeda in the Maghreb, which has been working there, Al-Qaeda in Africa, which is there. And we would certainly like to strengthen our cooperation with France in this particular field, along with the intelligence sharing among the relevant agencies.
One of the cross-cutting themes of Prime Minister Europe's trip is Make in India campaign, economic agenda, seeking investment to fructify the India story. Mm-hmm. How do you look at this dimension of the Prime Minister's visit, and what can we expect?
Well, I spoke about the defense dimension, the strategic dimension, let me put it like this. If we come to the other areas, I think one of the key sectors will be the sector of smart cities. And this is something which is extremely important. We have seen this is a subject which is very close to the heart of this particular government. They are putting a lot of emphasis on it. And some of the global leaders in urban planning, urban infrastructure, urban transportation, water management, sewage management, public sanitation are French companies. And I think I would not be surprised if this area comes up for a major focus. In addition to that, we also have about more than 700 French companies who are working in India. The French investment in India, if we take the total investment in India, would be of the range of about more than $10 billion. And these include companies like Alstom, which are in power distribution, power generation, companies like Air Liquide and so on, but a whole range of vast French enterprises. Among the areas which I think also could be a subject of focus would be agro-processing. As you know, France has very rich tradition of food and they focus a lot on agro-processing. Some of the global leaders are French companies in this sector. So these are some of the areas which I think could contribute a lot to the idea of Make in India, in addition to the strategic dimension, which would be the nuclear, space and defense.
The Modi government has launched a wave of second generation economic reform, which has opened up economy, service sector, FDI. And there is a buzz that, you know, French companies are especially excited about the insurance sector. What are the key sectors of economy where we can expect French investments to come in?
Well, financial services certainly. In fact, the biggest French company in the area of financial services is Capgemini, and Capgemini employs something like 60,000 people in India alone. And the co-CEO is an Indian of Capgemini. So while financial services is certainly an area which would see an inflow of investment, but I think manufacturing particularly and agro-processing particularly would be other sectors which can also contribute to generating jobs in India, which is an absolutely important and urgent demand for the Indian economy if we have to reach growth levels of 8, 9, 10%.
Coming back to civil nuclear cooperation, Ariva is planning to set up 6 reactors in Jaitapur. There are still lingering issues relating to civil nuclear liability and possibly other issues. Do you see a resolution of these issues in the run-up or close to the trip?
Well, the French companies have had some concerns about liability, and from what I understand, they are quite reassured with the kind of understanding that has just been concluded with the United States. I'm quite sure that the government of India, or NPCIL, will be in a position to provide similar assurances both to French companies or to Indian suppliers, because Indian suppliers are equally concerned about liability provisions. Once these are out of the way, then it is just a question of working out the financial and technical details, the costing and pricing negotiations, the technology transfer details and so on. And hopefully we should see that 2 of the 6 reactors being supposed to be built by Ariva at Jaitapur are being fast-tracked. And I think we will see some movement on that as well.
You spoke about robust defense cooperation between the two countries. France is betting big time on the Rafale deal. Do you see a closure of this deal in the near future? Do you think the Modi-Hollande talks will give the political push for the closure of the deal?
I'm quite sure it will. These negotiations have been going on for some time. Understandably, these are very complex negotiations. And we are also moving into new areas like life cycle costings and so on, which are a new experience for us. And there can't be a bigger political push than a summit level meeting between the Prime Minister and the President.
So Prime Minister goes to Paris in April, and you know Paris in April probably looks the best. Talking about cultural cooperation, the India story, we have a cultural festival from both sides. In that area, what can we expect?
In many ways, Paris is considered the cultural capital of Europe at least. And one thing which is very interesting is that the French people have always been very open to Indian culture. In fact, if you see, Indian cinema was first celebrated and given a global platform in France. And even now, among the new Indian producers and directors, they always get an opening at the famous Cannes Film Festival. In addition to that, there is a very strong school of French academicians, French dancers who have specialized in Indian languages, Indian culture, Indian dance and Indian music. And many of them live here and they provide a very solid bridge between the two countries. And almost every year we have a number of festivals organized in small cities in France which are known as Festival de l'Inde.
There are reports that India and France are going to cooperate in the Indian Ocean region. There is talk about what is called the 24 Nations Radar Surveillance System.
Yes.
Could you give a sense of, you know, you're talking about the strategic dimension of the relationship, in what areas you can work together in the Indian Ocean, what does it mean for regional stability against the backdrop of China's growing influence, or presence, or at least a projected attempt to do so?
You know, a lot of people don't realize, but France is like an Indian Ocean power, because among their overseas territories is the Reunion Islands. The French population in their overseas territories in the Indian Ocean is about 1 million strong. And out of that, about 1/4 of the population, 250,000, is of Indian origin. And France has a naval presence both in Reunion as well as in Djibouti. Our navies have worked together in anti-piracy operations, and there is talk that as we develop, as Prime Minister Modi, when he was recently visiting Sri Lanka, Seychelles and Mauritius, in Mauritius particularly, he laid out Indian Ocean policy for the first time. And I think there he said that while we would be expanding our presence and our role in the Indian Ocean, we would also like to work with other like-minded partners. We also saw that when President Obama was here, one of the statements that came out of that summit level was the joint statement on Indian Ocean and the Asia Pacific. So clearly, we can see growing area of cooperation, given the fact that France is an Indian Ocean entity. We can see greater cooperation in the Indian Ocean among our maritime resources.
You can sum up in a few sentences. What is the way ahead for India-France relations?
I think the India-France relations, the strategic partnership, is something which has very strong roots and it will continue to prosper. There are strong roots in the cultural field which will continue to sustain ourselves. What we need to build up is the fact that we need to build stronger economic ties, more Indian companies. You know, Indian investment in France is about $1 billion, which is a very small part of outgoing Indian FDI. So we need to expand that, particularly with the French small and medium scale enterprises. At the same time, France needs to get into the Indian growth story in a much bigger way, in terms of manufacturing sector, sectors of aerospace like Airbus, which can enormously support the development of aerospace industry, which again is a priority area for us. The smart cities and planning of urban infrastructure, development of urban infrastructure is another major area. Fast trains, you know, we are talking about urban transportation, metros and fast trains, intercity fast trains, another major area of potential cooperation. France has always prided itself on the idea of a strategic autonomy, something which is very similar to Indian foreign policy and its articulation. So I think there is a convergence in ideological terms, and certainly there is a lot of scope for taking it forward by making concrete measures in the economic field.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
On a different track, you know, we are doing a separate thing on Afghanistan, and it's a kind of feel good thing on India, Afghanistan. Delhi-Kabul bonding. There was just one question on India's role in the reconstruction of Afghanistan, especially now as you look at it. That's a more complicated question. But in general, the kind of role India has played in Afghanistan.
India began its economic assistance program in Afghanistan after the fall of the Taliban in 2002. And since then, we have committed more than $2 billion in a wide variety of economic assistance programs. These cover humanitarian programs of rebuilding hospitals, providing medical care, setting up medical teams and so on. These include infrastructure projects of power transmission lines. These include schools, vocational training centers, dams and so on. And these include also an enormous focus on capacity development. Afghanistan, which has been subjected to internal conflict for more than 30, 40 years, has lost an entire generation because of that. And President Karzai always used to say that the biggest resource is the human capital, which is where he sought Indian assistance. So in terms of providing short-term courses, vocational training, in terms of giving scholarships to Afghan students to come to India, in terms of training their civil servants, in terms of training their pilots for their airlines, you name it, in all of these areas, we have provided training to Afghan civil society. So this is some of the most significant kind of cooperation, and it is This is also a cooperation that cuts across all ethnic lines, all regions of Afghanistan, South Afghanistan, North Afghanistan, East, West, it doesn't matter. And that's the reason why today, in poll after poll, if the Afghans are asked as to which is their favorite country, you know, the phrase used is sabse pasandida mulk. The answer 10 out of 10 times is India.